Hello. On this video, I'm going to show you how to pass information from one page to another page using ASP.NET C# and the HTTP GET method. So I'm going to start a new project. So first, I'm going to create the index page. And now, I'm going to set it as a starting page. Right here on the form, I do not need to run at server. I'm going to delete this, but I do need the method to be get, very important. And the action is going to be a second page. So let's create a second page. I go back to the index and I can set this as a second page. Inside the form, I'm going to put a couple of inputs. And the second input is for me to submit this form. So type submit, value submit. Now on the second page, I'm going to delete the form and I'm going to create a couple of ASP labels. Label ID equals LBL city. Run at server, that's very important. And now on the CS file of the second page, on the page load method, I'm going to get the information. I'm going to declare a variable city equals request dot query string, and here is the name of the variable that it's coming from the first page. So if I go to the first page, I know that the name of this input is city, so this must match this. And now, I'm going to print it on the label that we created on the second page. Text equals city. So now, this city here is the variable that I created here. So now, let's run the code. So this is our first page. Type something. And submit. Now it goes to the second page. Now if you note, right here on the URL, the value that you passed is right here in the URL. So that means that the value you're passing is very unsafe. So don't use for anything that you do not want the user to know about. Now what if I'm gonna pass a second variable? Well, just go back to your index and create another input, and now I'm going to put the input's going to be age. So city, I'm going to put a break right here, and age, and another break. So the age is what I'm passing to the second page, and on the second page I need to create a string page from user equals request dot query string and age. So now the second page has the age from the user. Note that I purposely changed the name of the variable only to show you that the name of the variable does not need to match the query string. Now this value here must match whatever is coming from the first page. So on the second page, I'm going to create another label. And now I'm going to name this LBL age. User age. And now I can print the age from user on that label we created. So it's label user age dot text equals age from user. So let's run this website. City, Seattle, and age 21. Submit. And on the second page, you have Seattle and age. And notice that the values are right here on the URL. If you look right here on this line, you don't have to put the query string. You can delete the query string and put request only. And if you leave like this, without the query string, this is going to work just as fine. Let's test it. Now the city is going to be Tokyo and the age is going to be 100. And on the second page I have 100 in Tokyo the same way. So this, in this case right here, works just as well as this one here. However, I would like to highly recommend you to still put the query string right here. And the reason is because query string is going to be a little bit faster, and also if you just use a request, you might be getting a different data than you're expecting. So always use query string. Thanks for watching this video. This is very easy and you can do it.